Thank you very much. I think that you are all experts here, and you know region very well, and I don't like to repeat the facts which have been mentioned already or are known, but just to remind you a little bit the Macedonian story. The country was got independence in 91, as Slovenia and Croatia did, and then they got UN membership under the name former Yugoslav Republic of Macedonia in 93. Then Greece recognized the country 2 years later. In 2005, Macedonia became a candidate for EU membership. And in 2008, there was a Greek blockade on NATO invitation of Macedonia over objections to the country's name. This is quite a long story or history. But let's mention one more fact. In 2011, the International Court of Justice in The Hague rules that Greece was wrong to block Macedonia's bid to join NATO, but the ruling didn't have any particular influence on the issue. And in February 2018, Greece said the dispute over the name of Macedonia could be resolved within months. At the level of the Prime Minister, this was true, this happened 2 days ago, agreement was signed. I would say that many stakeholders were engaged, all European institutions, of course Mr. Nemec, bilateral teams led by Prime Ministers. There was also strong contribution from the European Parliament, which has been involved also through, I would say, special troika led by Mr. Kukan, our colleague from the parliament. Many players welcomed the agreement, which I have to say, this welcoming spirit was not shared by everybody. No, in Greece, no, in FYROM, you know that there were protests on both sides, and I will not describe this disagreement, which I suppose is known to you. It consists of 20 articles, and it is not just about the so-called name issue. It was not just the problem what will happen with the name. There is also the question how the adjective Macedonian will be or should be used, and so on. This will have quite many technical consequences, let's say so, because many things will have to be changed, not just the constitution, what is a particularly sensitive issue. I would like to make a very political comment. I'm head of delegation, parliamentary delegation to joint parliamentary committee to Macedonia, and such delegations or committees are responsible for all relations between EU and Macedonia, and I will not comment the articles. But I would like to comment the spirit. So after 27 years, or after 10 years of 2 more minutes.
Oh, apologies, this is a 2 minute marker, so you have 2 minutes left to speak.
2 minutes more?
Yes.
Okay, fine, thank you, it's quite a lot. I think that the spirit is different. What 2 prime ministers did definitely led to a new momentum. And now the political question is whether this agreement will be endorsed by 2 sides. It's quite a demanding, politically demanding process, but I think that we should take into account the consequences if this agreement is not endorsed. No? Who and when will be able to come with a better solution? This is the question. We saw the consequences of the blockade. Now we see an attempt which resulted in a signed agreement. And we know that with agreements we are never satisfied in all respects, but such agreements can lead countries to another quality or level of relations. And of course, if the agreement is endorsed, this means, I will be very short, NATO membership and opening of accession negotiations. And there is not just the problem on between two partners, there is also the question how European Union entirely or member states will react to that. I would suggest that this we don't consider, that no member country considers this achievement as a kind of problem for deepening of the European Union before the next enactment. Thank you.